So when Apple announced the new MacBook Pro lineup last week, they described them as having Thunderbolt 3 ports. And this may be confusing to a lot of people who think, well, I don't need Thunderbolt 3, I need USB. Well, in fact, they're one and the same. The new port is probably better described as a USB-C port. And USB-C shaped ports work with both USB and with Thunderbolt. You can plug either of them into it. So here you could see at Apple's website the specs for the new MacBook Pros. You can see it, they describe them as two Thunderbolt 3 ports, or four for the larger one, with support for charging. So you can charge your MacBook through it. There isn't a separate port that just is for the charger. You can output DisplayPort, or in fact any kind of display, like HDMI or VGA for instance, with the right cable. And you can do, of course, Thunderbolt and USB 3.1, so the latest version of USB. You can plug any of these into there. Now, since USB supports a ton of different types of peripherals, there's pretty much no limit to what you can do. And Thunderbolt can support a ton of different things too, like hard drives, video accessories, things like that. So it's basically one port to handle all sorts of different information. So let's start with looking at USB. So USB has had two different port sizes over the last few years. You can see it here at the Wikipedia page. Here's the standard port, which you're probably familiar with. And there's also this other port called B. So this is USB-A, this is USB-B. And USB-B usually you see like at the backs of printers or other large peripherals. So you have a cable that goes from A to B. And that's how it's been done for a while. But now there's also something called USB-C, and USB-C looks like this. And the advantages of USB-C, of course, is it can handle a lot more data, so they can up the speeds on USB to a lot more. And also, it doesn't matter which way you plug in the cable, you can plug it in right side up, upside down. There is no correct way. Both ways work, which is really nice because it's been frustrating all these years using USB-A, and everybody always seems to plug it in the wrong way the first time. Also, we've got Mini DisplayPort. Now, up until now, Thunderbolt ports and Mini DisplayPorts have the same shape as well, and they're kind of interchangeable in that if you have a Thunderbolt port, it could be used as Mini DisplayPort. So basically, Thunderbolt is a type of port that can also use Mini DisplayPort. Now, with the new type of port, you can actually go and use it for Thunderbolt and for Mini DisplayPort. It's a different shape, of course, so you're going to need to use a different cable. And this is the case with a lot of peripherals now. People are talking about dongles, but you don't really need dongles. Most devices, like say a screen, has a cable that goes from the screen to your Mac. Or a hard drive has a cable that goes from the hard drive to the Mac. And right now, if you've got a cable that goes to older USB-A ports or older Thunderbolt ports, you just need to get a newer cable, or in the future the devices will come with a cable that the other end is USB-C rather than either Mini DisplayPort or USB-A. Apple actually has a page about this here, and they talk a little bit about Thunderbolt 3 and how it relates to USB-C and the different things that you can do. For instance, hooking up HDMI display, a VGA display. You can even connect to your iPhone or iPad, which has a lightning connector, using a USB-C cable that they have, and you can get probably cheaper ones online as well. Of course, if you're at the cutting edge like I am, you rarely connect your iPhone and iPad to your Mac nowadays. You do it all wirelessly. But you do have the options to do all these, and people are talking a lot about little dongles, that they're going to need dongles. Well, in the case you do, I picked up like this little one right here. This just goes to USB-C on the one end and to USB-A on the other, so I can take any old USB device and use it on this. And it makes sense because this thing costs exactly $2 and it gets great reviews at Amazon, so I'm sure it'll work just fine. And it'll allow me, say, if I want to use my old SD card reader rather than buying a new one, for $2 I just extend it a bit, and my camera bag is pretty filled with little gadgets and lenses anyway, so adding one extra one really isn't that big a deal. And the next time I buy an SD card reader, it'll be a USB-C SD card reader.